वेरी वेरी चीयरफुल मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल प्रेजेंट हियर. आई एम नेहा रघुवंशी, ओके, एंड वेलकम हियर ऑन द ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ हरदा डिग्री कॉलेज. आई एम नेहा रघुवंशी एंड आई एम योर इंग्लिश एजुकेटर. एज वी नो दैट this is your exam time and you all are busy in your revision, and I hope that your preparation is going on, you are doing. So today I am here to discuss the some MCQs questions, okay. This is one sample paper of your English which having the multiple choice questions, okay. So today we will having a quick review of these all questions, which is very very important, okay, and useful for your preparation. So let's start. First question is about William Wordsworth belongs to England, France, Italy or Germany. So the correct answer is England, okay. This is the question based upon your poem Daffodils. Second, William Wordsworth is known as what kind of the poet actually he was? Classic poet, romantic poet, neoclassic poet or modernist poet? The correct answer is romantic poet, okay. Now we will go through another questions. William Wordsworth's The Daffodils is, means what kind of the poem? The William Wordsworth was the poet and he had written the poem Daffodils. So Daffodils is a what kind of poem? Nature based poem, okay. It signifies the nature, the beauty of our environment by the flowers daffodils. The title word daffodils indicates, jo title hai is poem ka, what does it indicates actually? Birds, trees, fruits or flowers? So we know that daffodils are the tall and yellow color flowers, okay, that grows especially in the spring season, okay. In the daffodils, Wordsworth looks upon the nature as something positive, negative, neutral or none of the above. The correct answer is positive, means here the poet trying to convince us that through these daffodils flowers, okay, some kinds of the positivity is spraying, okay, positivity aapki spread ho rahi hai everywhere, so it indicates the positive. The theme of the Wordsworth The Daffodils is, the correct answer is nature as a healing balm. ये बता रहे हैं कि जो नेचर है, नेचर को हम यहाँ पे प्रिटेंड कर रहे हैं. एक्चुअली द नेचर इज प्रिटेंडिंग लाइक अ हीलिंग बाम. हीलिंग इज अ प्रोसेस टू बिकम अगेन एंड अगेन हेल्दी, ओके. द कलर ऑफ डेफोडिल्स फ्लावर इज, वॉट काइंड ऑफ कलर ऑफ द डेफोडिल्स फ्लावर? हैव यू सीन द डेफोडिल्स फ्लावर? एक्चुअली इट इज द टॉल एंड येलो कलर फ्लावर, ओके. सो येलो इज नॉट हियर इन द ऑप्शन, बट सिमिलर टू द येलो लाइक अ गोल्डन. सो यू विल क्लिक ओवर हियर ऑन द गोल्डन ऑप्शन. गोल्डन इज द करेक्ट आंसर. द डेफोडिल्स फ्लावर रिप्रेजेंट, वॉट डज इट इंडिकेट्स, वॉट इट रिप्रेजेंट्स एक्चुअली? ह्यूमन लाइफ, एनिमल लाइफ और द नेचर? सो इन दिस पोयम इट सिग्निफाइज द नेचर. The daffodils flower blossomed. Blossomed मतलब खिलना. ये कब खिलता है? Basically, the daffodils flower blossomed beneath the tree and beside the lake. Okay, now in these questions, both are the answer A and B. So don't be tick separately on the A and B individually. Don't be tick. Okay, you are having the option D, both A and B. Okay, so tick this one. D option is correct one. If you will in exam point, if you will be tick separately on the A and B as well, so this will be wrong. Don't do, okay, don't repeat the mistake. The daffodils flowers were, daffodils flowers jo hai is poem mein, what basically they are doing? Wo kya kar rahe hain? What kind of action is going on? Flirting and dancing in the breeze. Okay, flirting and dancing, these both are the adjectives. The poet here used some kinds of the adjectives to describe the actions of the daffodils flower. Matlab breeze yani bahut achhi hawa chal rahi hai, okay, a cool air was blowing aur us air mein aapke jo flower hai, they are basically moving, wo dance kar rahe hai. So it pretends like they are dancing and fluttering. So the correct option is A. The daffodils flowers were stretched in. अब daffodils flowers को अगर हम देख रहे हैं, ओके, तो ये कहाँ तक stretched है, मतलब कहाँ तक बिखरे हुए हैं? The correct answer is A, never ending line. Option B is ended line, या row wise या none of the above. तो correct answer is never ending line. It means when you see the daffodils flowers, okay, in the particular field, तो it pretends like never ending line. ऐसा लग रहा है कि ये flowers बहुत दूर तक बिखरे हुए हैं और बिल्कुल भी मतलब खत्म नहीं हो रहे, एंडिंग लाइन नहीं है वहां पे, ओके, इट इज नॉट फिनिशिंग. So it was all the questions about your poem, which was the daffodils. Now we will move ahead towards the next question. That is the basically we have taken from your chapter, Bengal seller. Okay, Bengal seller. Who is the Sarojini Naidu? Sarojini Naidu was a doctor, lawyer, poet, and a reporter. So correct answer is a poet. And when was Sarojini Naidu born? Basically, she was born on the 13th February 1879. Okay, just remember this date. The next question is about where was the Sarojini Naidu born? Unka born kahan hua tha? In the Hyderabad. Okay, for confuse karne ke liye aapko, you will having the multiple kind of the options, but don't be confused if you know the correct answers. So you need to tick on the Hyderabad. Okay, now let's come on the towards our next question. That is, who is known as the Nightingale of an India? Here actually what we have done, we are comparing, okay, the Sarojini Naidu's voice with Nightingale. Nightingale is a one kind of the brown color bird which is having a very beautiful sound, okay, melodious sound. So who is known as the Nightingale of India? Correct answer is Sarojini Naidu. Sarojini Naidu is known as the Nightingale of which country? India, Pakistan, England and China. She was an Indian, okay, she born in India. So correct answer is definitely India only. Don't be confused here. The poem Bengal Sellers was written by, this poem was written by Sarojini Naidu. This all questions is about the Bengal Seller, which has written by the Sarojini Naidu, and she was the poet. She born in the Hyderabad. Now the same questions from that poem directly we have taken. Who or dash, okay, wears gold flecked purple or gray bangles? Flecked, it means we can say small dots or patches of the color, okay, on something, that is called the flagged. तो किसने ऐसे purple और grey bangles पहने थे जिसपे color के अलग अलग patches और dots थे या mark थे? Mother, maid, bride and old woman. तो correct answer is was mother, okay. Now according to the poem, the next question is that dash wears the bright rainbow colored tinted bangles. Tinted matlab slightly colored, okay, not fully colored, slightly colored. So correct answer was D, both A and B. And what are my options A and B? A happy daughter and a happy wife. In dono ne tinted color ke bangles pehne the, matlab the bangles was slightly colored. The correct option is D, both A and B. Okay, so this was all the questions about the sailor, okay, the poem Bengal Seller. Now we will come ahead towards our next topic in your syllabus, and it was all about the APJ Kalam. Who was APJ Kalam? As we all know that he was the most famous and the popular identity, okay, the president of our India. APJ Abdul Kalam was born in, he was born in 1931. You need to choose the A option. A is the correct one. Okay, 1931. The date of birth, what is the date of birth of the APJ Kalam? The correct answer is 15 October 1931. वहाँ पे जितने भी options होंगे, most possibility है कि it will be regarding on the particular October month, क्योंकि उनका born October month में ही हुआ था. But don't be confused, okay? If you know the proper answer, 15 October 1931. APJ Abdul Kalam was born in, now in which state he was born? So he was born in the Tamil Nadu, okay, Tamil Nadu was the correct option. And where exactly in the Tamil Nadu? My next question is that only. So in the Rameshwaram, okay, Rameshwaram mein unka born hua tha. Now what is the full name of the Kalams? Kalams ka full name kya hai? Okay, many options were there, but correct option is A, Abul Pakir Jainulabdin Kalam. This is the full name. Okay. Now, this is the questions regarding the another chapter which we have taken from A Letter to the God. Okay. You are having this chapter in your syllabus. The first question is that in this chapter, where was the Lencho's house situated? Lencho ka jo house tha, wo kahan tha basically? Lencho was the name of the one boy, okay, who was the main character in this poem. Bottom of the hill, top of a hill, top of the plateau in a city. The correct answer is top of a hill. Hill ke bilkul top pe tha. What was the only thing that the earth needed according to the Lencho? The correct answer is shower. It means rain. Okay. Actually, the Lencho was having the demand of the shower, of the rainfall. Okay. Where did the Lencho expect the downpour to come from? Downpour, it means heavy rainfall. Okay, suddenly rainfall जो होता है तो वो कहाँ से expect कर रहा था कि heavy rainfall होना चाहिए, from which direction? तो you need to choose the northeast. Okay, northeast direction. Now the next question, what did the Lencho compare the large raindrops with? Actually when it was rain, so it was like coins. Okay, so here silver coins, pearls, diamonds or the new coins. So it was like a new coins. New coins was the correct answer. Which crop was growing in the Lencho's field? Okay, you are having the multiple options. The correct answer is corn, bhutta. Okay, makai jise hum kehte hain. So corn was the only the crops that was growing in the Lencho's field. Next, what destroyed the Lencho's field? Actually, जो उसकी crops थी तो क्या हुआ था जिस वजह से उसकी crop destroyed हो गई थी, पूरी खराब हो गई थी? The correct answer was hailstorm. Hailstorm means a fall of the, heavily fall of the hail. Hail, it means जो ओले गिरते हैं, जब ओलों की बारिश होती है, that is called a hailstorm. Okay? The field looked as if it were covered in like a salt. Salt is the correct options. Okay. You are having the multiple options, the locust, sugar and ice. Locust is means a very flying insects hote hain generally that are moving in a large group and that eat the plants and damage and destroy the whole plants in a large quantity. Okay. That is called the locust. But don't choose, this is not the right answer, salt. What was the only hope left in the hearts of the Lencho's family? Lencho की family में एक उम्मीद रह गई थी, तो वो last उम्मीद क्या थी जो उन्हें अभी भी उम्मीद थी, क्योंकि बहुत ज़्यादा नुकसान हुआ था, उनको loss हुआ था, but still they have the some hope and that was only the hope, help from the God. Still they had the hope कि अभी भी उन्हें उम्मीद थी भगवान से कि भगवान उनकी मदद ज़रूर करेंगे, help from the God. C, okay? C option, third option, help from the God you need to choose. How much money did the Lenchos ask for? Okay, तो जो Lencho था, Lencho ने कितने money की demand की थी from the God? 100 pesos. Pesos is the monetary, standard monetary unit, okay, which generally we use in the Latin American countries like Philippines, Mexico's, okay. तो यहाँ पर हम ये monetary standard unit measure करते हैं money के reference में, उसे हम कहते हैं pesos. Okay, next question. What was the immediate reactions of the postman on seeing the letter? जब postman ने वो letter देखा तो उसका सबसे पहला reaction क्या था? Okay? The correct answer is laughed wholeheartedly. It means वो दिल खोल के उसे हंसी आ गई कि ये what kind of person he is writing the letter to the God. तो definitely आपको भी अगर आप सोचोगे कि कोई person है और जो directly God को letter लिख रहा है, तो ये सोचकर ही हमें हंसी आ जाएगी. तो same reactions was the done by the postman as well. Okay, laughed wholeheartedly. The postmaster was a fat, amiable man. What is the meaning of the amiable? Amiable मतलब होता है the person who is having a very friendly manner, very pleasant manner, okay? Who is a very extrovert kind of the person. So we will choose here friendly. Friendly है, helpful है, rude है, enthusiastic. Enthusiastic means full of excitement and full of interest. So the correct option was friendly, friendly and pleasant manner. Next question is, God sees the truth but wait. This is the another topic started, okay? The God sees the truth but waits. This is the title of your main chapter. So it was an, what kind of story? It was an American, Indian, Russian story. What kind of? It was the Russian story, okay? So correct answer is D. Russian story it was. Who is the author of God sees the truth but waits? किसने लिखा है ये? ये आपका चैप्टर, हु वॉज द ऑथर? तो डोंट बी कन्फ्यूज, यू हैव टू लर्न द नेम प्रॉपरली. नन अदर देन ओनली वन, लियो टॉल्स्टॉय. ओके, लियो टॉल्स्टॉय. गॉड सीज द ट्रूथ बट वेट, दिस इज वॉट काइंड ऑफ स्टोरी? शॉर्ट स्टोरी, लॉन्ग स्टोरी, नॉवेल है या प्ले है? सो बेसिकली इट वॉज अ वेरी शॉर्ट स्टोरी. ओके, God sees the truth but waits was published in which year basically this chapter published? Okay, first time. So we will consider 1872. देखिए आप जितने भी options हैं all are in terms of 18. Don't be confused. 1872 is the correct one. Okay, God sees the truth but wait is a story about a man named, this is the Aksinov. 42. He saw a snake. Dash, he awoke. Now this is the grammatical based questions actually. He saw a snake. Dash, he awoke. And you have to be choose either then, when, then, and no word needed. उसने स्नेक देखा. This is the past tense. वो देख चुका है. देखने का काम complete हो गया है. But when, कब देखा उसने? When he awoke, जब वो नींद से जागा. Okay? वो जाग चुका है. तो here the correct option is when. When he awoke. जैसे उसने स्नेक देखा जब वो नींद से जागा. Okay. 43. The cell phone is both cheap dash best. This is the conjunction based questions. यहाँ आपको एक conjunctions का use करना है कि cell phone दोनों हैं. Cheap भी है, सस्ता भी है और क्या है? Best है. So these both are the quality. Okay? Cheap है और best है. Quality है ये cell phone की. तो ये दोनों quality है. So here we will use the and. Okay? Correct option is B. The cell phone is both cheap and best. And, okay, conjunction क्या करता है? Basically, it joins the two words or maybe join the two different sentence. Srashti will go dash Sanju goes. This is the conditional base statement. Okay, यहाँ पर conditions है. कि Srashti will go, Srashti जाएगी, dash Sanju go. वो तब ही जाएगी जब Sanju जाएगा. So, you need to put the if. If हम generally condition based statements के लिए use करते हैं. तो आपका sentence हो जाएगा, Srashti will go if Sanju go. Srashti भी जाएगी यदि Sanju जाता है. Okay? So, correct answer is if. Now, this is the jumbled type of sentence. Okay? Here, you need to put the sentence properly in a proper sequence. Rearrange the given jumbled sentence. The sentence were there, but it is not having a proper meaning. Okay, so you need to be read properly and try to rearrange it. You are having the multiple options, but you need to choose the correct one. So the last Sunday, the railway platform was particularly busy. This one is the correct statement. Okay, you need to put the answer A. You need to choose. Last Sunday, the railway platform was particularly busy. बाकी में आप देखोगे तो कुछ ना कुछ एरर मिलेगी. यहाँ से आपका संडे से स्टार्ट हो रहा है सेंटेंस. फ्रॉम हियर इन द सी ऑप्शन डायरेक्टली यू हैव स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द रेलवे प्लेटफॉर्म एंड लास्ट संडे रेलवे प्लेटफॉर्म वॉज बिजी पर्टिकुलरली. सो इट इज नॉट परफेक्ट सेंटेंस. ए वन इज द करेक्ट वन. इन द 46 द सेम क्वेश्चन अगेन. यू नीड टू रीअरेंज द क्वेश्चन. ओके, सुधा इज वर्किंग हार्ड. देखो जब भी आप सेंटेंस इस तरह के आप जंबल वर्ड देखोगे आपको एक वर्ड ऐसा मिलेगा जो कैपिटल लेटर में है. ओके, सो हियर सुधा एंड दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द पर्सन. सो डेफिनेटली योर सेंटेंस वुड स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द सुधा. ओके, ये दो ही सेंटेंस ऐसे हैं जो सुधा से स्टार्ट हो रहे हैं. बाकी इसमें कैपिटल लेटर से हम सेंटेंस स्टार्ट नहीं कर रहे हैं. नाउ सुधा इज योर सब्जेक्ट. आफ्टर सब्जेक्ट हेल्पिंग वर्ब यू नीड टू यूज. इज योर हेल्पिंग वर्ब, तो इज आ गया. ओके, सब्जेक्ट हेल्पिंग वर्ब. नाउ मेन वर्ब यू नीड टू यूज. व्हाट इज योर मेन वर्ब? दैट इज एक्शन. व्हाट द सुधा इज डूइंग एक्चुअली? तो सुधा इज वर्किंग. तो वर्किंग, ओके, सुधा इज वर्किंग हार्ड. कैसे काम कर रही है सुधा? हार्डली. इन ऑर्डर टू बी द बेस्ट इन हर क्लास. ओके, वो क्लास में बहुत ज़्यादा हार्ड वर्क कर रही है ताकि वो बेस्ट कैटेगरी में आ सके. सो ए इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. यहाँ आप देखोगे द नहीं है. ओके, सुधा इज वर्किंग हार्ड टू बी द बेस्ट इन हर क्लास. एंड वॉट अबाउट द इन ऑर्डर टू? आपको ये पूरे वर्ड्स आपके सेंटेंस में इंक्लूड करने हैं. तो यू नीड टू बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल वैन यू ट्राई टू अटेम्प्ट सच काइंड ऑफ द क्वेश्चन. ओके, नाउ 47 नंबर क्वेश्चन. चूज द अप्रोप्रिएट ऑप्शन विद द करेक्ट पंचुएशन मार्क्स. ओके, दिस क्वेश्चन इज बेस्ड अपॉन द पंचुएशन मार्क्स. आई हैव बॉट अ बुक, टू पेन्स, अ पेंसिल एंड एन इरेजर. So many things you are having. Here we having the multiple things. So we need to be put the some punctuation marks, okay, to separate all these things with each other. Okay, ये सारी चीज़ें अलग अलग हैं. I have bought a book. आपने, मैंने एक book खरीदी. खरीदने का काम पूरा हो गया है. Now put the semicolon. Okay, अब क्या क्या खरीदा आपने? Now आप वो बता रहे हो. Two pens, a pencil and an eraser. यहाँ पर आपने हाइफ़न यूज़ किया है. आई हैव बॉट अ बुक, ओके, कॉमा, टू पेन्स, अगेन यहाँ पे सेमी कॉलन आ गया है. सो दिस इज़ ऑल्सो नॉट द करेक्ट आंसर. करेक्ट आंसर इज डी. आई हैव बॉट अ बुक, टू पेन्स, अ पेंसिल एंड एन इरेजर. ओके, हमने इन सभी को कॉमा का यूज़ किया है और सेपरेट किया है. ओके, So answer D is the right one. 48 number questions. Choose the sentence with the correct punctuations. Again, this is a punctuation based questions. The captain ordered the troops. Captain ne troops ko order diya. Kya order diya? What was the order? March forward. Okay. आप देखोगे द कैप्टन ऑर्डर द ट्रूप्स देन वी नीड टू पुट द कॉमा टेक अ पॉज एंड देन व्हेन समबडी गिव एनी इंस्ट्रक्शन ओके और गिव एनी स्टेटमेंट तो उस स्टेटमेंट को हम हमेशा कोटेशन मार्क में इनक्लोज करते हैं ओके तो मार्च फॉरवर्डेड इट वॉज द कमांड ओके ऑर्डर गिवन बाय द कैप्टन सो वी हैव इनक्लोज इट इन टू द कोटेशन मार्क ओके स्टेटमेंट तो ए ऑप्शन इज द करेक्ट वन क्लियर 49 नंबर का आपका क्वेश्चन है दैट इज होल्ड वंस हॉर्स दिस इज वन ऑफ द फेमस ईडियम आई थिंक यू ऑल आर नोन वेरी वेल होल्ड योर हॉर्सेस और होल्ड वंस हॉर्स इट मीन्स होता है हैव द पेशेंस ओके यू नीड टू हैव द पेशेंस इन योर सेल्फ दिस इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शंस ओके पुल योर शॉकअप्स इट मीन्स यू नीड टू इम्प्रूव इन योर सेल्फ So students, this was all the questions, whatever we have discussed, it was a one kind of the sample English paper. You need to have a quick review, okay, of all these questions and definitely it would be beneficial for you, for your preparations. Well, thank you. I think this is enough. Thank you. Have a nice day.